We continue our mobile repair course with this device, water damaged, Xiaomi Redmi Note 10 Pro, that doesn't turn on. The client confirms us that the device has been under water during 40 seconds. So I'm going to try to solve this Xiaomi Redmi Note 10 Pro water damaged. Quickly, we are going to disassemble the device, we are not going to take long. I'm surely that we've got a lot of work ahead. We remove the back cover, applying 90 Celsius degrees during 3 or 4 minutes, and with the help of the plastic P-guitar, we cut the adhesive. We proceed with our visual inspection, and as you can see, the screws doesn't have any sticker, which means that the device was worked before. The same on the bottom part. Now we remove the SIM tray, which is located on the top of the device. To find the motherboard, we have to remove the middle case. When we find the motherboard, the first step is to remove the battery connector. Then we can continue with the other connectors. Very important, our first visual inspection is essential. In this way, we can observe which areas were affected by the water. The same we do with the bottom part of the device. Here, in this area, we've got a lot of corrosion. This area doesn't worry me because the most important thing is to recover the function of the motherboard. Now we remove this metal sheet. It can be easily removed without heat. I remove it because I found signs of humidity here. Now we are going to remove this shield. It's the shield that protects the CPU and the memory. To lift it, I use 420 Celsius degrees and 80% air. Accidentally, I have moved this plastic connector. On more than one occasion, this can happen to you. Don't panic, this is your work and we have to know how to solder and desolder any component on the motherboard. We apply a little flux and we solder the connector. We use 300 Celsius degrees and 40% air, and in this way we don't take any risk. Now, with the help of the microscope, we inspect the motherboard. As you can see, we have removed the shield and all the components are intact in their places. You have to lose the fear of removing these shields. Before working with functional devices, you have to make tests on broken phones. Each air station is different and the temperature of each laboratory is different. There are many factors that influence the working temperature, such as humidity, altitude, model of the heat station. Now we are going to clean these plastic connectors. Due to the salty water, they have oxidized too much. To clean it, I use a piece of cotton and contact cleaner. This capacitor is burned and has lost its properties. For the moment, I prefer to remove it, and if I'll solve this device, then I replace it. For the moment, I think I'm going to remove even the other capacitor. Now, we scrape the pads and then we apply flux and solder paste. With the help of the solder iron at 350 Celsius degrees, we review the pads. We have removed the other capacitor. When a specific area presents corrosion, it's better to remove the integrated circuit and to check it. We apply a good flux and we solder it again. We are going to clean this antenna as well. We follow the same steps. We apply a little contact cleaner and a piece of cotton. After cleaning the motherboard, we are going to proceed with the measurements. This line is in a short circuit. We apply a little flux and we remove this bobbin. In this way, we know on each side is the short circuit. The short circuit, in our case, is on the top part, so we are going to remove the CPU. We apply a little flux and we'll use the hot air station at 380 Celsius degrees and 40% air. When the CPU moves, it can be removed. Now we have to replace the old solder paste with the new one. We apply a little solder paste of 138 Celsius degrees and flux. To remove the excess of flux, we use a piece of cotton and contact cleaner. In the same way, we clean the motherboard. We apply flux, solder paste, and the solder iron at 350 Celsius degrees. This step is very important because we have to leave the surface flat. In this way, we'll not have any problem when we are going to solder the CPU. Now we are going to measure again. We put a multimeter in diode mode with the red tip to ground, and with the black tip we measure the components. The short circuit, it has disappeared. Now it's time to reball the CPU. With the help of the plastic tool, we apply solder paste of 183 Celsius degrees. We clean the area with a microfiber cloth, and then we apply heat with the hot air station. The truth is that the temperature doesn't matter, just lower the airflow to 20%. You can use between 300 and 350 Celsius degrees. Here we have our CPU ready. The CPU has to be treated as if it were a normal integrated circuit. In the same way, we can do reballing with the main memory and the RAM. We place the CPU and we apply heat. I'll use 380 Celsius degrees and 30% air. We can observe how the CPU has positioned itself. When the solder lead melts, the integrated circuits are placed perfectly in their position. If you think that your CPU is not soldered well, then you can give it small touches in the corners. The circuit has to return to its initial position. We apply a little solder paste and we solder the bobbin. We use the same temperature and the same airflow. About the microscopes, you can start with an economic one and then, little by little, after generating money, you can buy some professional microscope. That's how I started. I started with the magnifying glass and then I bought a binocular microscope, and now I have two Amscope microscopes and an optics cam camera to record. This is the bottom part of the device. Here we have the charging module. I'm not going to take too long with this class. We are not going to waste time with cleaning the charging connector. We are going to assemble our device and check what's happened. It seems that our Xiaomi device doesn't have enough battery. After the contact with the water, the battery is protected and drops below 3.5 volts. We'll put it in charge for a couple of minutes. Now yes, our device has a good charge. We try to turn it on. It seems that our device wants to turn on, but the screen presents lines. We leave it a little bit in charge and then we try to turn it on again. Our Xiaomi Redmi device turns on perfectly, the screen has been burned internally and present lines and has been left without touch. Now we are going to test a new screen, a new spare part, and as you can see, the screen works correctly. In the case of this device, we'll charge to the final customer the price of the screen and we'll apply him a good discount on the price of the cleaning process. Let's say that we always try to find a fair price and we have a satisfied customer.